Thank you. us with these wonderful students, and I want to thank all the directors and families who've made it possible for these students to travel here. We also are just thrilled to share that we have students representing 90 high schools from 5 states, all the way from Alaska to Wyoming, and also from Alberta, Canada, which is amazing for these wonderful students to be able to sit next to people they might not otherwise ever be around. We're especially thrilled to welcome esteemed and celebrated composer Julie Giroux, who is here and has been conducting, working with the students, and of course sharing her amazing music. I'm also really happy to welcome Dr. Emily Moss, who is here from the University of New Mexico, director of bands there. We are also so happy to feature our own Dr. Kevin Graves, who is the associate director of bands here at UM and director of our Grizzly Marching Band. Make sure you're here next Saturday to cheer us on. And Dr. Jim Smart. Dr. James Smart is our director of bands and also newly appointed director of the School of Music. At this time, I'd like to welcome Dr. Hannah Ransom and our all-star steel band. Yay!
Thank you so much, everybody. I just wanted to say a couple words about what you're about to hear. This all-star steel band features the senior percussionists from each of the 3 all-star concert bands. These instruments are from Trinidad and Tobago, and this is just one of the opportunities at UM Percussion that we have to play instruments and music from around the world. It's been such a joy to work with these students. Most of them have not played these instruments before, and they picked it up so fast. We just had a couple of rehearsals, and they've just shown great musicianship and willingness to explore and to improvise. You'll also hear today on drums, Dr. Jake Ransom, my husband, who stepped in to play drums with us. So this tune is called Yellow Bird. It's a Haitian traditional folk tune arranged for steel band. Thank you so much.
Thank you. you. I am Dr. Kevin Griggs, and I've been here at UM for 20 years now, and been able to see the All-Star program grow and develop, and so many students that have come through this program. Since we have a few of our percussionists in this great steel band group, I'm going to give them a chance to get back and get settled. We'll be doing four selections for you, and each one has information in the program notes that make it easy to understand what it is we're doing and how the sounds combine. Our first tune is Stealing Home, and the program notes read, in baseball, stealing home plate is an extraordinary event, a mental battle of the player's mind that either ends in ultimate failure or ultimate glory. With a fanfare style, stealing home begins with the excitement and anticipation of the game. The ebb and flow of the game are represented with an energetic buildup throughout the music. As the plays unfold, the hopeful baseball player waits for just the right moment. When the game is on the line, a moment appears in the distance like a spark igniting. He seizes the opportunity and throws caution to the wind. He goes for it, stunning everyone in the ballpark by stealing home plate.
Thank you.
was telling the students during rehearsal that sometimes the talking that we do between tunes is just to give the percussion a chance to get a new set of toys out and retune the symphony. When I taught high school years ago, I remember being in my own world, focused on what was coming next, turned the page, went to get the downbeat, and the look of panic on my percussionist's face taught me never to do that. So always give them a chance to get set before moving on. The next tune is called The Time to Dance, and the program notes are actually taken from Ecclesiastes, which is a very well-known verse. It says, "For everything there is a season, and a time for every purpose under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to break down and a time to build up, a time to weep and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance." So this is a tune that uses that upbeat dance feel to express those emotions that really can only be done during dance. And the nice thing about dance is it's often accompanied by music. And so this is A Time to Dance, and we will hopefully be able to depict that sense of joyous dance that the music calls for.
Thank you.
making sure we have all of the procedures taken care of here. For this selection, we are very fortunate to have our guest composer who's been here with us through all of All Star, and all of the music is from her pen. And we're going to be pleased to have the next piece conducted by Ms. Julie Giroux.
It's hollow. And over the past 500 years, there have been Japanese families that take care of the bonsai tree. And when family members pass, then the next people pick it up. So, and I got to meet the current ones that were taking care of it. But, you know, during World War II, they had to evacuate it, and it did get a little burned from it. And other than that, they managed to keep it safe over the past 500 years, which was, you know, pretty incredible. And it was just so small, and it was just amazing that something so small could mean so much to a country, and it really does. So I had to write about it, and that's what I'm going to perform for you, the bonsai tree.
Thank you.
We've been able to work with these great students over the last couple of days, and as the conductors of these groups, we're asked to find a student that has just sort of set themselves apart a little bit as an all-star among the all-stars. It's a difficult thing to try and decide on because there's so many. In fact, the entire group, we think, has worked so hard, any one of them could be recognized, so that complicates the matter. But in the days we've been working, had to select a single individual, and we have the baton signed by Julie Giroux, and that's sort of the recognition for a student who really has done a great job in helping the group that they're in. And from this group, it's one of our tuba players, Kane Everly. Selection with the Copper Band, and then we'll have hopefully not too large of a change for Silver Band. This last one is titled Dream Dancer, and it has a very short program note. It says, "Dreams, magical world where anything can happen. To enter this inner sanctum, you must fall asleep and drift far, far away into the realm of your own subconscious and imagination. Anything can happen. The sky is not the limit. It is the perfect place to dance." So thank you for being here to see Copper Band, and I know you'll be thrilled with the remaining performances. This is Dream Dancer.
Thank you. greeting. That is our official greeting, the Silver Band. All right. Hi, everybody. My name is Emily Moss. I am the director of bands at the University of New Mexico, and it has been an incredible weekend with these fine young people you see. I'm going to briefly talk about our opening piece because it's got a little something interesting in its title and its message. It's called Beyond the Gate. And the idea is that we all have inner demons that you might be keeping in or trying to hold out. And while this may be something that you struggle with, and we had a lot of good conversation about what it's like to be a young person these days and the demons we may face and struggle with, in the end there is hope and beauty and love in the world. So we hope you can see both the dark and the lightness in this piece, and this is our first selection for you, Beyond the Gate.
Thank you.
And we get to welcome Miss Julie Giroux back up to the stage. Julie. They don't care. They don't care if you sit in that room forever. They're fine. So I tend to rescue dogs. I've had all kinds of rescues. And when I was asked to write this piece for these three bands, they pretty much let me do whatever I want to do. But I thought, you know, I had just adopted like the ugliest dog in the world. Seriously. He had half a million followers because he was that ugly. So I thought, I'd really love to write a piece about adopting a dog, but I thought, oh, that's the happy, you know, they paid me to write them a piece of music, not about animals. So I thought, well, I'll call and ask and see what they think. And they were like, the woman that I talked to first, the band director, said, oh my God, yes, we have adopted a gerbil and a rabbit and a horse. And I was like, oh my God, they're further than I am. And so all three of the commissioning managers had adopted pets, so they were fine with me writing this piece. So I don't know how old this piece is, but all of the proceeds from this piece go to rescues, no kill shelters. And so it's had a lot of play everywhere, and they do it outside, and pets are there, and people can donate food. So it's turned out to be, as a whim, something that has ended up being a really great thing. So this music is for all of those pets. Thank you.
Thank you.
this weekend. Such great camaraderie with these students. It's so important, I think, to build community and realize that we're all in this together in this musical adventure that we have. Like Kevin, my colleague before me with the cover band, it's very difficult to have to select one. And if only I could give one to each section or even each person. But I went for, sorry about the squeaking here, everybody. I went for maybe someone that would not be as obvious, but someone who I felt connected with all weekend and gave such wonderful responses to all the open-ended questions. It was just a solid musical presence right in the center of the band. Zoe Keller, bass clarinet, my all-star. Come on.
Thank you. Thank you. You don't know much about Miss Drew. All the kids know is that she's awesome at video games, and she's kind of writes for them and plays them a lot. But she has credits dating back to the 80s in film and in television and video games, and written for orchestras and written for bands. It's just amazing. So it's been a real treat. She's also just the most genuine, real human being. So please, welcome back to the stage, Miss Julie Drew.
Before the sun. My dad was in the Air Force, and so we traveled all over. And we ended up moving to a very, the school, I think the school was 140 people in the school, and this was in Arkansas. Now, I know that you have very remote locations here, but I promise you, there are parts of Arkansas where people are practically feral. So. I wish I was kidding, too. So we moved to this really small place of Arizona, from Phoenix, actually, and we lived across the street from a farm, and we ended up having, you know, some farm animals also, and it was amazing to me how much happened before the sun ever came up. In fact, everything happened before the sun came up, and then people would come in and have breakfast. And so that's pretty much what the piece is about. And you don't really hear violin in a band very often. And I was really excited to write that for this piece, because to me it really captures that loneliness and that, I don't know, it's Americana really. And so I was really happy to do this, and she's phenomenal, and we've had a great time. So I hope you enjoy it Before the Sun.
Thank you. so polite. So I've got some awards. I'm gonna be real quick here. What's this one? Oh, this one's pretty much, it may be faster to get to Minneapolis than Missoula, but I still live in Montana. Plentywood High School, two students from Plentywood. Mind text message to 240 kids, and some kids were like, my high school only has 500 in it. I'm like, no, you're not gonna get it. It was cute though. Anyway, the smallest high school is gonna be Plevna High School. So, Plevna High School also. Next year when I ask, don't respond unless you have under 50. All right. The longest drive, period. The longest drive. Paul from Laramie. Paul.
Oh, Paul's a mystery.
It's like a football game. I should have one of those air guns that shoot the t-shirts. These are really cool ones. So, this is the furthest away, period. May not have traveled by car, but I don't know if you knew, but Anchorage got like 2 feet of snow on Tuesday, Wednesday, and we had Alaskans make it, like all of them except for one. But one is from a little bit further than everybody else, from Soldotna High School in Alaska. Madeline Ross, where's Madeline? Madeline, there you go. Last one, we had a half dozen kids from this school that were set to come. Only one managed to get across the border. It's what makes us an international event. This is Tavis Duke from Lethbridge Collegiate. I just have to do that because honestly, when I tell people about this experience, this all-star band, they're like, was it all kids from Montana? I said, no. No. It's really remarkable the distances people have come for this event, and it makes it really, really special. And I just want to let everyone, no matter if you had a 2-block drive or a 14-hour drive, right? And no matter how many time zones you come across, I mean, it's sincerely appreciated, everything. So I also have the Golden Baton. The Golden Baton, as the other conductors have said, could go to anybody in the band. But I did choose one young lady who's just always positive, always willing to do like changes and just amend things and just always awake, no glazing over the eyes at all, no matter what. And it's Miss Claire Silly from Graham Kapowsin High School in Graham, Washington.
People. I'm going to do it very quickly. So the people who run this theater, Aaron Torgerson and all the Denison crew, have been on it for, I mean, it feels like they haven't had a break yet. Like, so I hope they have a happy Thanksgiving because they've been here every day in and day out for way too long, and they're just amazing. So. All my wonderful colleagues in the School of Music who gave some mini lessons to seniors, gave sectionals to everybody, the administration in the College of Arts and Media from Dean Jennifer Cavanaugh and Dean Michael Music on down. So a huge thanks to those people. To the nominating band directors, many of whom are in the audience, they're the ones who actually create the skills in these students so that I get to kind of mess around and do fun pieces of music. All the band directors. And this applause is going to come from here, back here, but it wouldn't happen without parent investment and a lot of patience and a lot of investment. So please, thank you to the parents. I also have to thank all of the UM students. I've ruined 2 weekends this semester with Allstate 3 weeks ago. Now this, I haven't ruined it. They've been here and they've enjoyed every moment of it. And they better get used to it because they're going to be band directors. But they've been behind the scenes, throwing stands and chairs and guiding kids and cleaning up messes after the meals and stuff like that. So all the UM music students, non-majors and majors, please give them a round of applause. Last but not least, everybody who is playing in the bands, all three bands, with their conductors, Dr. Kevin Briggs, Dr. Emily Moss, Miss Julie Giroux, and all of you guys, thank you so much for all of you. The last slide after we play our last piece, it does say, thank you for coming, safe travels, and see you next fall. And I mean that. For everyone, even the seniors.